Hi, everyone. My name is Michael Wicks. I'm one of the MCs for the WholeLife Expo. So we're just putting this on CD and tape, so we're just getting a proper introduction. So obviously, most of you probably know Douglas James Cottrell, one of the Canada's Edgar Casey, as he's been called by. I've had my own experience with Douglas at North York Library upstairs. Maybe some of you have been up there. Yeah. So my experience was I went up there, and he asked me what I wanted, and I said just heal, just wherever I can be healed. And he then said something to me that I won't repeat now, but there's no way he could have known or should have known this kind of personal information, other than he has obvious gifts from God of sorts. And then at the end, I mean, a number of people fell down onto the ground and shook, which was quite amazing. But the last person, or the second last gentleman, just started crying uncontrollably. And I think it went on for 10 minutes, and he was sobbing. And it was quite an amazing experience to watch that. And then he stood up and started smiling. So there's some great healing to occur here, I would think, tonight as well. So let's not waste any more time. The good news is there's no one after speaking after, so there's no problem. You can go on past the hour that's been allotted, and I'm sure no one's going to kick you out. So let's put our hand together and welcome Douglas James Cottrell.
God Almighty, I ask that you bless each and every one that has come here this evening, that they are relieved from their pain and their suffering, that there is instilled in them a sense of well-being, a sense of grace, wholeness, and healing on the physical, mental, emotional, and most importantly, the spiritual levels. So might it be. Amen. I always start my sessions with the words God Almighty, and people ask me why. Is it not proper to do so? We're coming before God Almighty, whether there's two or three of us, or in such an organization or setting or event such as this. And we're doing so because we expect something from the unseen and the great beyond. Each of us always asks, in times of crisis or difficulty, please help me. Whether you believe in a supreme being, God Almighty, Jesus Christ, Moses, Muhammad, Safia Sai Baba, Saroster, or others, you are asking to something beyond the moment, beyond yourself. And that something is real. And it's only real if you can witness evidence of its reality. Hence my motto, faith is built on belief, and belief is built on evidence. I have followed that consciously and unconsciously all of my life since the day I started to find out about the spiritual or metaphysical worlds. Now, even before that, I wondered, why are those words in the Bible written in italics? Why are some Bibles written in red and black? And whether I knew it or not, my quest for knowledge of the great beyond began then. I found out that the words in italics were the words the interpreters put into the text. Well, I stopped reading the italic words, and guess what? The text had a whole different meaning. The words written in red were allegedly Jesus Christ's words. Then I found out that many of the books in the Bible were independent books written at different times, somewhat long after the passing of Jesus Christ. So how could they be accurate? My questioning began then. And it's important that you question all the time those things that come to you that are important to you. It's important that you question the people that bring you the message, because they too are putting their interpretation on what they believe. It's important that you come to understand that all the holy books, all the scriptures, were never written by God. Has anybody seen the book of God? It doesn't exist. Because God exists in the great beyond. We all are seeking to develop our intuition. We all have spiritual or psychic ability. every single one of us. Yours might be clairvoyance, it might be clairsentience, it might be clairaudience, clear seeing, clear feeling. Clear hearing. I'm not audient. Matter of fact, I'm a little deaf in this one ear from a hockey game a couple years ago. Somebody didn't like the way I was playing hockey and taught me some respect. Hit me over the head with a hockey stick. He got 5 minutes, I got a hearing aid. Life is not fair. To develop your faith in the unseen, you have to have experiences, and those experiences have to be real. So real that you believe them. Let's face it, you do not have faith if you doubt. And in order to believe, you have to have evidence. Evidence that you can sense but one of the five physical senses that you have. Reward is here and now. Karma is here and now. It's not the next life. It's not in heaven. It's not in hell. Right now, you are the end result of everything you believe. Everything you believe. You want to improve your life, you want healing to occur, you have to change something. And tonight, change is going to occur, whether you believe me or doubt me. Tomorrow, when you wake up and you say, I think he pushed me over. Matter of fact, I'm sure he pushed me over. At least you've got something to talk about, but I am not going to push you over. It may feel that way. It may not. I've asked for God Almighty. I've asked for the angels and the spiritual guides and all the saints that have gone before us to assist us here tonight. What a team I have. And you know, that team can come to help you, and you, and you, and you, if you ask. You have to ask. And if you ask, then you must believe something, and you must have an expectation that your prayer, your question, your statement is going to be answered. And therein lies your spiritual progression at that moment. You will not be denied. If you want to have a long life, yes, you have to eat properly. Yes, you have to breathe properly. Yes, you have to exercise. Whether you play hockey or not, it's your business, but it's a good exercise. But the point being is you have to exercise, and above all, you have to believe in something. Beyond yourself is a power and a resource. It is so great that we cannot describe it. We don't know how it works, nor should we ever find out. But we know somewhat of how it works. Otherwise, we wouldn't ask God Almighty to help us in prayer. But if you believe in God, if you believe in something beyond yourself, whether it's an angel or a spirit guide, whatever, if you believe in the great beyond, you are strengthened and have unlimited resources. Where does everything go wrong? When people start to tell me what they believe. Because then they intend to impose their knowledge and their belief on me. And it doesn't work, because I don't believe. I only believe what I believe. Now, I'd like three people to come up here who want to take a chance, and I'd like the two gentlemen to come up here that has to help me. Send up and pick three. Well, look, they already lined up. Okay? Now, I want to get your attention. Stay right there. I'm assuming you can hear me with this microphone. Behind the lady, both of you. Do you believe? What do you want?
I would like to be healed body, mind, and soul.
I want you all to help me, and you'll see my hand build the energy. I want you all to think nice things about this lady. She wants just a healing energy. Yeah. What I'm doing is I'm increasing my aura. I'm expanding through my chakras that energy. You are as well. Some of you may feel warm, some is cool. And when I go up and I ask this lady, what do you want? It's like a bulldozer falling on her. She didn't even answer me, did she? Come, what do you want?
I want healing on all levels.
Now, I'm not pushing these people. Matter of fact, they're tripping me. Thank you. What do you want?
I want healing on all levels.
Come. I can't count. We'll do everybody later. If we got the time, you heard Michael say that we have extra time. What do you want?
That the child enjoy.
Take it. Don't resist. What are you doing?
I'm just afraid.
Don't be afraid. God Almighty protect this lady.
That's why we're here, don't worry.
Well, he almost dropped her. Do I have your attention? I don't know these people. The people in the room that know me, stand up. People that know me, stand up. Thank you. Those are the only people that know me in the room. Close your eyes right now and ask God Almighty, all the angels, all the spiritual guides, all the forces of good and creativity to come into you and to go to whatever you are thinking about now, wherever you want this energy to go to you, to heal you in a physical, mental, emotional, or spiritual level. Think of it now, clear, concise. Breathe the energy in and allow yourself to be healed. Dear Lord God Almighty, we ask for the healing forces, the creative forces, all that is holy, all that is creative to come into these people, into their wants, into their hearts, into their needs, into their minds, and most importantly, into the soul. Comfort them, guide them, assist them. Let their lives be changed, that there will be plenty in their lives. Amen. Feel the energy. Can you feel it? Is it warm in your chest? Take it. It's free. The thing about asking God Almighty is that God doesn't care whether you come to the ocean and ask for a cup of water or a tank full of water. It's yours to take. Do I have your attention? 31 years I have been doing this. For most of my 30 years, I've been meditating four times a day, doing deep trance meditations for people, in which I have given them specific information on their health, which I am very well known for. I've also conducted information sessions for people in commodities and stocks. I've made a lot of money on commodities myself, lost a lot of money as I listened to all those wonderful people that knew better than I how to take care of my money. They seem to take very good care of it in their pockets, but not mine. I've made money, yes. I've used my ability for practical means. I've used my abilities unselfishly. And that's what I'm doing here tonight. And in December, on December the 4th, at another place in Toronto, we'll be conducting another healing event, a miracle healing event, because what you're witnessing is miracles. What are miracles? It's the use of healing energy that's as yet not understood. Crazy glue 20 years ago was a miracle. Think about it. You took a cup, put a drop of stuff on, put it together, there it was, fixed. God is like crazy glue. We can't understand it. I'm cooking, I'm warm, I'm hot, because all the energy that you're right now helping me generate is coming through me. Take it for yourself. Take it. Believe it. Faith is built on belief, and belief is built on evidence. Here's evidence that there's energy going around this room tonight. I'm warm. Are you warm? Energy's going around this room. It'll cool off later, and you'll notice it because it'll stop. Ladies, are you? This is Anne, who acts as our soother. Who else wants to come up here? Now, this always happens, please. I didn't get to my lecture yet. And who knows, I didn't study it that well anyway, but we'll do a few people at a time, and then we'll try to get to everybody, okay? Take your time. Everybody wants to experience it first time, firsthand. What do you want?
Spiritual and physical healing.
Whatever that means, what do you want? Hi.
Hi, Douglas. I've been doing so much better. And 2 weeks ago, I had a fall again.
Two.
Again.
Where do you hurt?
My knees, my head.
Okay, start with your head. I'm glad you're doing better. Come. Move. And move the easel. What do you want?
I would like to heal my soul.
Come. What do you want?
Rheumatoid arthritis. I want all my joints to be returned to normal and my rheumatoid arthritis to be gone.
You'll notice I put my hands in different places. One solar plexus for the soul. That lady had arthritis. I tried to put it through her spine. I am conducting the energy, but I'm not creating it. You are. I need you. How's that feel? Different. And what do you want?
Spiritual, emotional.
What do you want?
Healing all over.
Kind of knocks you down, doesn't it? Dear Lord God Almighty, we thank you for the demonstration of this healing energy. May it come into each and every one that is gathered here today, and may it change their faith, that they will have belief in the Supreme Being, in all that is good, all that is right, correct, peaceful, and good. Evil, get ye behind me, means simply this: let the doubt fall behind you. Look for the good, always. What I'm showing you tonight, what I'm showing you tonight is an example of what you can be too. Who taught me? Reverend Alec Holmes, Catherine Kluman. They showed me like I'm showing you. But God Almighty instilled in me this ability. Why? Because I asked. Look at your hands. You got a little cross here?
Yes.
You got thick palms? You're a healer. You're intuitive. You're psychic. I asked God Almighty to show me a sign that I had some spiritual ability, and the next day a little cross appeared in my right hand. I laid hands on someone, a relative, the lump on her neck disappeared. I was floating across the room thinking, this is amazing. I did it. Believe me, if you ask and you expect and you apply, no matter how long it takes, you will have amazing intuitive spiritual abilities that you can use in your own life and for your own purposes, whatever they are. Try always to do good. But you will do good and you will do not so good, but you will do. Come. What would you like? What do you want?
Blockages in my body.
You have blockages? Not anymore. Now what you're getting is a shot of energy. To sustain it, you have to continue to ask. Continue the healing God. Does that make sense? I know things when I'm in this state of mind that I would not consciously know otherwise, because I've changed my level of consciousness, my level of awareness. When I'm on the radio and somebody in Toledo says, "What do you see?" And I say, "You have a toothache, don't you, in the lower jaw?" He'll say, "That's amazing." And to me, I think that is amazing. Because I'm in London, the radio station's in Hamilton, and he's in Toledo. But my mind is in Toledo. And I didn't have to go across the border. You can mind project. You can remote view. You can balance auras. You can increase your Reiki healing effects. You can do everything, but you need to see it. You need to believe it. And you need to be here. Why? Because the energy goes through. It's cooling down, isn't it? I can feel it. Because you guys are giving up. You're thinking. You need to be enthusiastic. The other night I watched the Boston Bruins because they were pretty enthusiastic. I went over to Gretzky's restaurant to have a drink, and they were closing the place down early. Met Walter Gretzky there, the great one's father, and I went up with my big B that somebody put on my jacket. And he wasn't too kind to me. He was, "Yeah, how do you do?" I've met him 3 or 4 times before. And I went out of the restaurant thinking, "Well, what did I say?" I just said, "How are you, Walter? Good to see you again. Remember we did that article, blah, blah, blah." And then I realized I had a Boston Bruins logo on my shoulder. How are we doing over here? I thought I saw a Boston Bruins fan up here a second ago. Where'd she go? Okay, let's get the energy up again. Think of it. In ancient times, if you look on the temples, you will see, especially in the early Christian ones, faces bent over, looking down with their hands in this position. This is the position for healing. There is somewhat of an aura crossing, goes through the chakras on your head between the pituitary and pineal, the psychic centers. This is the ancient way that people in groups healed each other. Can you feel yourself getting warmer now? What are we doing? We're generating that healing force. Generating that healing force. The spiritual part of us is assisting each and every one of us, and it is bringing it into our body. Every day, in every way, you should try to do this. And when you get cut off in traffic, don't swear. Think, "Where's that music?" You can think, "Jesus loves me," or "Lord Shiva," or anything else that brings you peace. Remember, don't focus your mind. People who study the roaster have this saying: good thoughts, good words, good deeds. It's a good thing to say. What do you want?
My eyes and my smile.
Now, normally I wear a robe for this. If you come in December and you see me, I'll be dressed in this black robe. Really kind of funny looking, but it works. The only trouble is people tend to grab it. And that thing's got more stitches in it than, I don't know. Over here. How are you doing, okay? Come. What do you want?
You'll look cancer.
I want everybody to imagine this man in this orange shirt, and I want you to imagine a flame, an altar of fire, flame burning on top of his solar plexus or tummy, gobbling up his problem, his disease, his illness. See it now, a huge bonfire, a huge flame. See the orange, see the purple, see the red, see the yellow, burning on his chest and his abdomen, bringing about a relief from his tumor, cancer, or disease. Relieve this man, save this man. Continue the healing that is taking place that he might be free. Let hope and enthusiasm show him his way, and let him always be in the spirit of enthusiasm. So might it be, amen. Come.
Come.
What do you want? Put your hands down. Take it. Have the faith, it'll catch you. I sent healing to this man's heart, to his soul, the seat. Come. What do you want, my friend?
To heal the cancer in my prostate and all parts of my body and all levels of my being.
Through our Lord, we ask for the cleansing flame to come into this body, to remove any cancer or any tumor or any diseasement within the body. We ask for the body to be filled with love and affection. Let all the anger to be removed from the body. We ask for the soul to be blessed with peace. Feel the heat. Warm?
Yeah.
All over?
Yes.
No tingly feeling yet? Good. Shiva. All locked up. Come. When you do this, you can assist the energy coming out of you by taking a deep breath and exhaling slowly. That's the positive, if they recall it. You know, in grade school, you say, in comes the good, out goes the bad. Not in meditation. As you exhale slowly, you'll feel the energy build up. Grunt. Stomach, your solar plexus together, and push, and you will feel the energy come out of you. Come. What do you want?
In my right inner ear and to my soul.
What I'm trying to do here is move the bones in his neck. Is it warm in your neck? Put your hands up over your head like this. Put your hands up like this. You've got to move the bones in your neck and keep them there. Sometimes, as this man can attest, the bones move on their own. Happened to him and a place where wherever we were, the bones in his back moved. Not because I pushed on them. Your body is the end result of what is going on in your mind right now. If you don't like where you are, change your mind. Every day, don't do the same thing as yesterday. Do something to make you enthusiastic. If I didn't like this watch, I'd give it to one of those fellows out on the sidewalk. I'd buy a new one first, but I'd give one away. I'm painting my house now. Why? Because I'm sick and tired of the darn color in the living room, in the kitchen, in the basement, and on and on. What am I telling you? Not that I'm an interior decorator or a painter. I don't like something, and I'm willing to pay the price to make a change. I'm willing to do something about it. That's what you have to do. You can touch upon the Akashic records. I have seen the future. I am clairvoyant. I'm expected to see the future, but I lost my cell phone the other night. I couldn't find it until I got home. I knew I was going to get it back the next day, and I knew it was on its side in a dark place, but where was it that night? I hadn't a clue. But my intuition said I was going to get it back, and I did. That's faith. My faith was instilled because I believed that this was going to happen because I took senses of how I was feeling. And I believed how I was feeling because I've had experience of how I was feeling. And the evidence that I was right, of course, was the next day. I'm embarrassed to say I had to call Rogers up and say, please turn my phone back on. Yes, I'm psychic. Yes, I can see the future. Yes, I know what you're thinking sometimes. Yes, I can see your aura. Yes, I can lay hands on you, make you feel better. But I'm still a person. Never forget, you are still a person, and that's why you're here. Those poor, stupid, misguided people that are suicide bombers are really, really surprised 2 seconds after they pull that detonator. Because Muhammad catches up to them and says, what are you doing? And they're saying, what? No virgins? No feast? What happened? And Muhammad said, I never told you to kill people. The born-again Christians, right, follow the teachings of Christ? No, they don't. Mahatma Gandhi said he loved Christ, but he hated Christians because they didn't follow Christ's teachings. They weren't charitable. If I can impress upon you anything, do not be a hypocrite. Yes, you will say you believe things, and the next day you'll do something incorrect or wrong. Forgive yourself and get on with it. Sooner or later, you'll get it right. And that's what life's all about. Later, you'll get it right. Sooner is better. Come. My hand's not shaking. Come on, you're not helping. That's it. What do you want? Pardon? God's loving energy, as opposed to God's other energy. God has a humor. He made me. You guys should be helping. Soothing. Come. Help the people up. Wherever you want to be, my friend, what do you want?
I've got a weird virus and I've got gallstones.
Just talk to make sure they're okay. You got gallstones?
Yes.
Okay, lots of watermelon. I don't know why, but that's what I see. Don't let people get you angry. When you're not sure, ask them, what did you mean? These poor guys, everybody's stepping over top of them here. Now, is that still warm in the back of your head? Which ear was it? What did you hear before?
I think it's better.
God, you gotta know. What do you want?
Alignment and lines.
Alignment?
Like spine. And
take a breath. Shoulders up, down. Something moved right there. Come. What do you want? That's what's causing problems with your tummy. Grapes, no empty tummy, grapes, no soda pop. Yes, grapes. And iodine. The diaphragm, relax the diaphragm. Are we still warm? Let's just wait a second. So I wanted to tell you before you go, and we're not ending this, I'll get to everybody in a second. There are four steps to achievement. This is the summary of my lecture. I worked hard and about 10 minutes on this. Plan purposefully. Prepare prayfully. Proceed positively and pursue persistently. And that's how you will become success. Plan it, see it, one thing. Not two or three, one thing. Our little brains can only do one thing at a time. We can only concentrate on one thing. Makes sense. Two, prepare prayfully. Invoke the creative force, the powers that are beyond us, the powers that are at your disposal right now. Angels, deceased relatives, gurus, saints, archangels, whatever, God Almighty. Proceed positively. There is no doubt you were going to come here tonight and you were going to see me and you were going to stand here in this line. When there is no doubt, there is no restriction. Pursue persistently. Don't give up. In my little life, 56 years next month, so many people give up at the last step, the last minute. Don't stop. And it shall be open. Seek and ye shall find. Sathya Baba is a living avatar, a God being. So are you. And I'm hoping to give you evidence tonight that the spiritual energy is not outside of you, not that it existed at the time of Moses and it's not here today, that the spiritual forces are alive and well in you and me and us now. Whatever your disease, whatever your hardship, whatever your problem, whatever your challenge, don't give up. In Toronto, we did the same thing, impromptu healing event. Two people, one in a wheelchair and one in a wheelchair walker. The wheelchair walker man asked for healing, got up and walked for the first time in many years. The other one said no thank you and scooted out the back door. Which one do you think had a chance of getting healed? Who wanted to be healed? Disease has its part, but it's not a natural state for the body to be in. Neither is spiritual poverty or financial poverty. Those are illnesses. Pray for plenty. Pray for God to send opportunities to you. Pray for God, God Almighty, to send you people who will bring you opportunities. All the other prayers are nice, but that's the most important, because God can provide opportunities. The forces beyond can provide opportunities and circumstance, but it's up to you to take hold, to seek them, use them to your best advantage. And there you have free will and free choice, what everybody's talking about here, from teacup readers and card readers to prophets. You do have free will and free choice, but you have to know how to ask. And the best way I've found to ask is not to be smarter than God and say, "Dear Lord, let me win that lottery," or "Let me have $1,000, or hope the bank manager gives me that loan." Those are things that are nice, and sometimes it's very important to ask for those kinds of things. But believe me, if you ask for opportunities and people to bring you opportunities and to have the wisdom to recognize them when they show up, you'll be a rich person on all levels, physically, mentally, spiritually, and financially. And most importantly, you'll have hope, you'll have peace, and you will only do the things that make you enthusiastic. Enthusiasm is the best sign to tell me that I'm on the right track. If you're enthusiastic about something, you'll live a long and productive and happy life, as long as you maintain that enthusiasm. I promise you that. That is the truth. It's a universal truth. When you start to lose your enthusiasm, problems are afoot. Fix them. And when you come to fixing problems, there are two things. One, if you have a cord around your ankle and you don't have somebody undoing it all the time, you will end up on the floor like I almost have twice tonight. In all seriousness, you have two options. Is it your responsibility or is it your duty? If it's your duty, that means that nobody else can solve the problem but you. So get on it. You will not like it. It will be difficult. It will be superhumanly hard to do, but it's your duty. Do it. Whatever it is, do it. If it's your responsibility, well, you can offload responsibility to people, you know. I have children. I get them to shovel the walk once in a while. Now that they're in their 30s, they tell me to shovel the walk. I need the exercise. That's not fair. If it's your responsibility, please be responsible. Or get somebody to take the responsibility for you and make sure that they live up to that responsibility. No mistake, though. If it's your duty, it's your duty, it's your duty. It's your karma, it's your life, it's your blessing. Somewhere in that poop, there's a pony. You ever heard that one? Two kids, one optimistic, one pessimistic. Father says, takes one, opens a door, and the pessimistic kid says, "Oh my God, who left all that poop there? Oh my God, it's going to be a terrible thing. It's dirty, it's filthy, blah, blah, blah." Pop takes a second boy, and he goes there, opens the door, sees all the manure, and he says, "Oh God, this is amazing. Well, all that poop in there, there must be a pony somewhere." Sorry I gave you the punchline before the story, but I'm dating myself. There is always, always, always a blessing. Disappointment, discouragement, or sometimes protection. But don't give up. Somewhere there's an answer to every physical problem in the world, even here tonight. When you go home, you may be healed physically, but I guarantee you, you are changed. Because when I started out tonight, what did I say? There are going to be changes here tonight. You are not the same person that walked in that door just a little while ago, because you've seen some light tonight. A glimmer, a flame, a burst. You have seen some light tonight, and never more, whether you doubt it or believe it, will you be the same? I've done my job. I give you light from one candle to another. Whether you keep that burning or not, your problem. Duty or responsibility? I trust you will keep it burning. I trust tomorrow you'll say, you know what I saw last night? This guy was amazing. Or this guy was a real so-and-so. Whatever you say, be kind. But say, he's coming to Toronto on December the 4th. Let's go see him again. I think he pushed me over. I want to see him do that again. This time I'm going to stand up tall. Come. What do you want?
I want to be healed.
Dear Lord, we ask for the healing energies to go through this body to eradicate the body of all its diseases, all its ailments, all its worries, all its pains. We ask for this energy to go through the body, through the heart, through the mind, and to the soul. Because at the soul level is where all diseasement takes place, not in the body first. Come. Doing a good job. Thank you, guys. What do you want? Where? Dear Lord, we ask for the burning, healing forces to remove cancer from this body, to instill in this body wholeness and wellness. Amen. Now I pray because I'm trying to direct the prayer. It's not my body, but I'm asking for those diseases, those ailments. Come. Just when the people are there, ask they're okay, and then help them up if they need to. Come. What would you like?
Financial abundance.
Abundance. Okay, see yourself. Jesus Christ prayed for money. Pray for money. Dear Lord, please send me opportunities to make money or people to bring me opportunities that I might have money. I pray for plenty. So might it be. Come. What do you want? Hiya. Let's go over here. I don't want people stepping on you. What do you want? Dear Lord, we ask for the sensitivity, the intuition to be heightened, protected, developed. Let there be loving grace in this mind and in this body. Let the awareness be clear. Those organs, centers in the body be opened. You like?
I've been told I have age-related macular degeneration. I have arthritis in my left eye. I have arthritis in my right breast and head. And the psychic told me that I have healing powers, but I don't seem to be able to access them for myself or others. I don't feel. But I'm not sure.
Everybody help me send this energy to this lady. Remove any arthritic conditions in her body. Remove the problems in her tummy. Let her healing forces come through. See? Took your help. Are you warm still? So am I. You're being healed now. Dear Lord God Almighty, bless me. Say it. Louder, I cannot hear you. Try this one, it's easier. God loves me, God loves me, God loves me. God loves me, God loves me, God loves me. I say that one every time somebody cuts me off. Truly, well, almost every time. I don't want to lie to you. Taxi cab almost ran into me tonight. And I was in my car. Come. Come. Are we having fun? Do I have your attention?
Yes.
Yes, what would you like? That's what you're doing here. By being here in the group with this energy, you will automatically guarantee your healing abilities because it opens people up. Dear Lord, we ask for the healing energies to go into this body, into this mind, and to assist this woman in all her needs. I guarantee you, your intuition is better, and it will get better. Come. You're doing a good job keeping me upright, by the way. Yes. Peace of mind. Dear Lord, we ask for peace of mind to come into this body. Don't let it worry, fret, or be afraid. That was easy. Come, sir. What would you like?
I'd like to experience God.
Every day and every way. Dear Lord, give this entity the feeling, the sense that you are with him. Let him come to understand that the little things he hears is God's mighty voice, because God does not talk in a booming voice. Anybody heard God talk? He doesn't say, Douglas, watch out. God will say, might be better if you took a flashlight. Believe me. How many times have you said, I knew I should have, right? I have a rule around my house, if I'm looking at a flashlight or a pair of scissors or a screwdriver or something catches my attention, I take it with me. Later on in the day, I or somebody I will be near will need that item. You're not done yet. Come on back. He wants the whole works. Okay, come. Now over here. Come. Sue there, talk to her. Christine, and talk to the lady. What do you want?
Emotional.
Emotions are the constructive or the destructive forces. Look for all the constructive forces. Don't be afraid. More iodine. Come. What do you want? Help me, I don't feel it. Look. Oh, there he goes. Come on. It's like a weather vane. Because, you know, it's going to take this lady a long time.
It's getting warm in your throat now. God loves you. God loves you. God loves you.
Remove the jealousy from you.
Let other people remove their jealousy from you. Breathe it in.
When I do that, it goes through both hands. This way it just pushes, okay? Understand? A bean. Come. What do you want?
Physical, mental, spiritual balance and equanimity. It's balance, health.
What do you want?
More energy.
More energy. Okay, went through the chakras. You feel that go through you?
Not really.
Did you feel warm in your head or in your tummy?
It felt a little warmer when you put your hand on my stomach.
Okay, well, we tried to line them up so you have more energy. And you have a little problem right here. Right there. This will make you breathe easier or breathe in. Well, use the whole part of your lungs instead of just the top. There you go. That's better.
Thank you.
Yeah. You're in pretty good shape. I paid $800 for a wireless lapel microphone. And at the time, I thought, $800. This is the first lapel mic I've ever had a little appendage going on. And now I'm thinking, only $800. Thank God I didn't get one of these. Come. What do you want? When I was younger, I had an operation to remove my tonsils. I've regretted it ever since. We just send energy into this lady's tonsils in her throat so that it would heal. Feel it getting cooler? You're quitting on me. It's hard doing this stuff, pushing this out all the time. But believe me, you're taking it in. It affects your intuition, affects your creative force. And sometimes it's really amazing to see what happens. At these events, we have had what we call expulsions. Those are negative thought forms in people who leave. They are dynamic and dramatic, and the person's forever changed. But you are changed as well. And I'm not trying to shun you people by being over on that side. I'm right-handed, so I'm a little heavier and I kind of gravitate over to that side. So pardon me for spending too much time with those people on the right side, my right side. Come. Take a breath, everybody. Push it out. And tomorrow, if some of you are doing healing out there and exhibitors, we'll expect to see a lot of people being healed all over the show, won't we? I'll be at my booth and I'll be doing demonstrations every couple of hours. So if you want to bring somebody tomorrow, I'll be doing this for small groups of people. And if you want to come back for some more, feel free. And of course, in December, there's a ticket available there. I don't hope it'd be commercial, but that's a. What would you like?
I'd like the helium.
Okay, everybody, I'm going to send healing energy into this tummy to relieve the conditions of resentments, the conditions of nervousness, and to bring a degree of peace and continuity in the function of the body and the stomach. We ask for relief in the neck.
It is amazing how sometimes you can feel it just kind of goes into you. Sometimes has been described as electricity. I did it again. Sometimes feels like a cloud around you, sometimes sparkly, and sometimes just like warm air. And those are the expressions, the feelings people have given to me. But each and every one of you feels the energy in your own way, whether you're at the front or the back, the left or the right. I'm trying to be a candle to let you take the light for yourself. Come. The more you do this every day, practice.